India Skill Report also has a greater insight towards India Hiring Intent 2020. And the demand story is very, very good. Despite that India has gone and the world has gone this pandemic, the jobs outlook 2020 looks to be still better. Increasing globalization, demographic changes, emerging technologies, regulatory framework, and geopolitical scenario will significantly influence India's job landscape in the coming years. With initiatives such as Skill India or efforts in the direction of investing in infrastructural changes, ramping up of micro entrepreneurship models and boosting the startup ecosystem, the government of India is clearly laying out signs that it is up for reinventing the business case for India. In addition, the rapid changing technology environment is reshaping entire organization structures and operations. It has led to the rise of new business models disrupting the incumbents, altered customer behavior, reformed service delivery methods and operations. And most importantly, it has changed the way people work. Some striking examples that instantly come to the mind are Swiggy, Oyo, Big Basket, Ola and Lenskart, the brands which have revolutionized the entire business ecosystem. As we head towards a knowledge-driven and tech-enabled workplace, repetitive and low-skill jobs are increasingly being automated using technologies like robotics, artificial intelligence, and machine learning. The key emerging digital technologies are creating new arrangements for labor market called the gig economy. So it is therefore necessary that India Inc. identifies and understands the changing job landscape and the emerging new roles due to these disruptions. Further, it needs to look at the skills that its workforce currently possesses and the skills that it will need in the future so that leaders can devise solutions to develop these new skills. It is observed that despite a huge population of energetic youth in the country, today, the industry is complaining of scarce talent. To understand this problem better and answer what can be done, we conducted an online survey, the India Hiring Intent 2020, with more than 150 employers across 9 industries to understand the challenges in hiring the candidates they want. The leaders also shared their views on the kind of roles or skills the organizations would seek in their prospective employees. Where do they plan to hire and what channels would they prefer to reach out the candidates? So the 2020 survey result, the Hiring India Hiring Intent 2020 survey result says that positive hiring outlook despite the sluggish economy. 56% of the industry employers in 2020 survey reported a positive outlook on the hiring and about 28% maintained the status quo. The figures, however, dropped this year as compared to 2019, where 64% of respondents reflected a positive intent, while 25% of respondents mentioned they do not intend to increase or decrease their hiring state. And the industry which are going to pioneer in the hiring intent will be e-commerce, internet business to the tune of 60%, banking and financial service and insurance, BFSI, to the tune of 35%, software, hardware and IT will be 12%, BPO, KPO and ITES to the tune of 30%, automotive 5%, manufacturing again 0 to 5%, pharma healthcare 10%, telecom and allied 8%, others diversified will take up to the tune of 5% more. 67% of smaller organizations show a positive hiring intent. Now on hiring spree, e-commerce and BFSI to be the job creation engine in 2020. Who will be getting hired more? Then yet again this year, mostly the candidate with 1 to 5 years of experience are in demand. And 40% employers across industry said that overall hiring is expected to increase and the demand for the freshers has been declining only 15% in comparison to last 3 years. Hiring intent by education domain, engineers are expected to be hired about 31%, closely followed by general graduates, that those are 25%. MBA would definitely be of a greater importance. The overall demand for the engineers has increased from last year by around 10%. MBA and postgraduate student as compared to previous year, in contrast to last year, the demand for the industrial training institute and polytechnic pass outs has dropped significantly. So engineering graduates, there's a good news for them. What is getting hired is positive attitude and soft skills are must. And when asked about the skills that employers seek while hiring, all employers explicitly mention the requisite of positive attitude in the candidate, with the sense that a candidate with a positive outlook towards job and learning is more likely to do better in her or his professional career and his or her counterparts. The unanimous voice of HR experts, as per discussion during the Decoding Jobs 2019, the Think Tank Roundtable series also placed a lot of importance on the attitude of candidate. Further, qualitative findings of the discussion held during the Decoding Jobs 2019, the Think Tank Roundtable series are mentioned in subsequent section of this report as well. Now, the employers mention what is of most important highlight, which we all need to pay attention to, is the employers mention top 5 preferred skills in a candidate while hiring. And those 5 preferred skills are positive attitude, adaptability, learning agility. Learning ability is different than learning agility, how agile we are to the new learning, the new technological learning that are coming our way. Domain expertise is something that is very, very going into the micro level and asking for an engineer, let's say if it he or she is a mechanical engineer, then the designing part, if the candidate is having a great expertise in the designing part, will be what be minutely taken note of. And the most important part is interpersonal skills, which is a larger skills and which has smaller skills into it, which has leadership, listening, communication, taking initiative, planning, organizing, problem solving, decision making, and all higher order skills comes under this particular skills called as interpersonal skills. So I repeat, positive attitude, adaptability, learning agility, domain expertise, and interpersonal skills are the most 5 preferred skills in a candidate while hiring, which most of the employers have mentioned. Upcoming new skills would be, the employer cited the increasing role of data science and analysis and social media marketing in the coming 5 years in the industry, and this is due to ever increasing role of advanced technology. So emerging job areas or skills in next 5 years would be data science and analysis, digital marketing, robotics, process automation, human-centered design, and compliance. So 5 job areas for next 5 years. Now, satisfaction with talent hired would be 57% of the respondent in the survey felt that only some or very few of the job seekers satisfy their skills requirements. So there is a lot to be done in particular, very specific to what has been asked from the industry, and what is that as a gap which every aspiring job aspirant needs to take care and note of. Right. So how many job seekers were able to satisfy the skill? Only 53% of the employers feel that some job seekers satisfy their requirement. So 53%, that means a lot is to be done here. So women participation is a big concern, because the gender parity will exist in the year 2020 as well. Now, it clearly says is 2019, there were around 75% of the gender parity, 75%, 25%. Now it has got reduced, and it has come to 71 to 29 as male to female ratio. Right, the gender diversity is seen all across all industry. Percentage hires by employment type, about 80% of the workforce constituted by permanent employees, while gigs stand at 13%. So contractual and apprentices or freelancing takes the other half. Now preferred employee type would be again going for a different nature, where telecom, allied, pharma, IT, and other diversified taking the major chunk. Employees prefer permanence over short-term engagements. 55% of permanent hires and 35% as compared to. In fact, the automotive sector witnessed a larger chunk of employees in contractual roles, about 35%, as compared to 55% permanent hires. So the reports talk about hiring gig, overall 13% of the gig workforce across all industry. Tier 2 and 3 cities would be hired more. Hiring by city increasing employment opportunities in tier 2 and 3 cities due to increasing gig workforce. Now, the most important is hiring by source channel. If you take into account the consultants, were 16% earlier in 2019, which has reduced to 14%. Campus hire from 10% to 11%, so it will go a marginal, percentage higher. Internal referral will be reduced from 19% to 14%. Professional working and social media will definitely increase substantially from 8% to 15%. Company websites will be again be taking a major focus from 6% to 10%. Job portals, not great difference, but 28% to 21%, so it is reducing. Job fairs perhaps would be major focus from 2% to 4%. Direct walk-in does not change much, 8% to 9%, and others does not change. So job portals, internal references, and professional networking and social media remain most used channels to find candidate. So now most of the job aspirant would have an answer where to seek job froms. Nearly 50% employees recruit through government-initiated programs as well and are happy with the skills of the candidate. So that means whatever the government scheme which are approaching the institute or the colleges should be taken seriously. Now, the top 5 states ever for where the maximum hiring will be done is indicated as Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Maharashtra, Andhra Pradesh, and Delhi. So West, North, and South will be the chunk of highest recruitment in the coming years.